Radhe Radhe, Dandavad Pranam. Today I would like to share something about another really, really wonderful song which is deep in my heart and which I love very much. It is the song called Shri Shri Guru Ashtakam, which glorifies Shri Gurudev in all verses in various ways, and which also is full of deep, deep meanings for our Gaudiya Vaishnava philosophy and for application in our daily life, and to go deep into this wonderful song. So many really wonderful topics are hidden in these verses, and when we take it apart and look inside these beautiful verses from Srila Vishwanath Chakravartipad, we can see that so many nectarian points are there to relish for us. So what I heard from sadhus and from my Gurudev, I wanted to share here about these really, really wonderful verses. The first one is, I will sing the verses and then explain, what I can think about it or what I heard about it. Samsaradava nalalita loka Pranaya karunya gana ganaryam Praptasya kalyana gunana vacha Pande guru si charana ravindam. So in the first verse, glorifies Guru Tattvai as something really wonderful. Samsara Dava Nanalita Loka describes actually our present situation even more today. About this, samsara is the worldly existence, birth, the wheel of birth and death. And Davanalalita Loka, the world, forest fire of our daily existence. And Lita Loka means suffering, and Loka means planet or people or mankind or living entities. So actually we are in a situation where we really, like I said in the Bhagavad Gita, from the end up to Brahmaloka, we are subjected to birth and death, and our body is subjected to suffering in the threefold miseries. Here is it called suffering by our own mind, suffering by someone else, and suffering by nature. So we cannot escape suffering. So samsara dava nalalita loka, Srila Chakravartipad is pointing out that it is actually a forest fire. It is severe, and actually there is only one method to extinguish a forest fire, and that is the rain or water, rain clouds. So chanaya karuna gana ganatyam, this suffering can be liberated by mercy, by a rain cloud. Gana ganatyam, by a rain cloud full of karunya, mercy. So who is this wonderful rain cloud full of mercy? It is Sri Gurudev Praptasya Kalyana Gunana Vasya, who is an ocean of wonderful spiritual qualities. And he appears to us as our savior in this matter, to save us and to rescue us from this forest fire of material existence. And he is compared to a big, big rain cloud filled with the rain of nectar of karuna, of mercy. So the translation would be like, the spiritual master is an ocean of transcendental qualities and auspicious qualities to save and to rescue all living entities who are burning in a forest fire of material existence, and to liberate them. He showers like a rain cloud his wonderful compassion and mercy. I respectfully bring my obeisances to the lotus feet of such a spiritual master. Vande Guru Si Charanaravindam. I respect my respectful obeisances. I offer my respectful obeisances to the lotus feet of such a spiritual master, who by his fantastic qualities and because he is Sadguru, he can liberate us from this suffering of material existence. And therefore, I take shelter at his lotus feet. He is qualified, because Krishna says in the Bhagavatam, I am I am Guru is me. We are not different. So the mercy of Guru is the only way to extinguish the material existence, the forest fire of material existence. And he lets the mercy rain like a rain cloud, and we have to open our heart and we have to receive that wonderful rain, that wonderful mercy. And we have to be careful that our bucket, our container has no holes, so that we can receive that mercy fully. Holes are explained that the holes in this bucket or in this container are our anattas, like we are proud, we are envious and all these things. If we can have a container which is not full of holes, we can grasp and receive this wonderful mercy streaming from Sri Gurudev, who is like a wonderful rain cloud of mercy. Beautiful verse for us. So next verse is called, I sing again, Mahaprabho Kir Sanani Chakita Varitya Maryan Manasora Sena Roman Chakampa Sutharananga Bajo Pande Guru Si Charanaravindam. Mahaprabhu Kirtanan Ritya Gita Vaditya Machan Manasurasena. Following the many, there are like different levels of this verse. One is inspired or taking Mahaprabhu's singing, dancing, and singing, dancing, making music, and taking this as an example. Sri Gurudev relishes wonderful transcendental mellows in his heart, so much so that hairs are standing on end and he experiences transcendental ecstasy. So kirtana means singing, nritya means dancing, gita means singing, and vaditra means music. So inspired by the example of Mahaprabhu, his sankirtan of Mahaprabhu, Sri Gurudev is always relishing, first of all, that when he is in meditation, that sankirtan in Mahaprabhu in Navadvipa, but also here in our world, he also relishes during kirtan all this singing, dancing, and he will experience and relish it so much so the transcendental symptoms of ecstasy can be visible on his body. So the translation would be like singing the holy names, dancing in an ecstasy, singing and making music. The spiritual master, inspired by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is always full of pleasure because he can taste this rasa of pure devotion in his heart. Sometimes his hairs are standing on end and a lightning bolt is running through his body and tears are running out of his eyes. So such a spiritual master, I bow down and I bring my respectful obeisances to his lotus feet. So here is a very important point made, that kirtan and singing and dancing and making music for the pleasure of the Supreme Personality of God, for Sri Sri Radha and Krishna, is eternal. It is in Navadvipa, it is in Vrindavan. So it is for the sadhak a very pleasurable way to perform bhakti by doing this. And by doing this, we also please Sri Guru, because he himself also relishes these activities. Kirtan, you do kirtan, you hear, you think about, you play instruments, and many senses are involved in that. So also it goes a little deeper, for in our parivara we can also take part eternally in the lila of Mahaprabhu as a sadhak there. So this verse can also be taken that Gurudev in his form in Gaura Lila, he relishes that in eternal Gaura Lila. So we can also see it like that. But mainly for us, it means that these activities, kirtan and bhajan singing, are very, very pleasurable, a very good way of bhakti, and it's pleasing to the spiritual master when he sees us doing this. So this is also a very important way of practicing bhakti, kirtan. This is really in this verse. So the next verse, again, another example of a bhakti anga, of an item of bhakti yoga. Shri Vikrahara Tanani Janana Shringara Tan Mandira Marchanaro
Yuktasya Bhaktam Schani Yonchatopi Vande Guru Sri Charana Ravindam.
Here the aspect of Thakurji Seva is mentioned, is prominent in this verse. Sri Vikrahara Dana Nityanana, permanent service to the form as a Vikraha of the Lord, the deity form Ishtadev. The Guru is always engaged in putting opulence in a temple, ornamenting the temple, cleaning the temple, ornamenting the deity, worshipping the deity, offering something to the deity. And I saw it every when I was in Radhakunda, my Gurudev was still alive. I could see that he was doing this every morning. He came down his stairs and every morning he was doing Sri Vikrahara Nana Nityanana. He was doing this seva to his beloved Thakurji Shishi Radha Kalachandra. So he, as an example, he lives that and shows us how to worship Sri Vikraha, the deity form, our Ishtadev. Is it now Radha Krishna? Is it the Govardhanshila? Is it Gornitai? So we, by his example, he teaches the disciple how to worship, how to do deity worship. And when you receive Diksha Mantras, it is a very, very important aspect of our sadhana life that we worship our deities in the morning. Differently, every parivat does it different. You offer boga, you offer incense, you offer ghee lamp, flowers, and puja, arjana. So Thakurji worship, Sri Vikrahara, Dana Nityanana is a very, very important point. And he, Gurudev, is very pleased when he can engage us in that matter. And to such a spiritual master, I offer my most humble obeisances because he teaches us and he shows us how to do actually Thakurji Seva, how to worship. I remember Gurudev telling me this has to be done and this has to be done. And when I received my Govardhanshila from Babaji Maharaj Gurudev, he told me exactly what to do, how to do it. And it was very funny and very, very nice and merciful. So Thakurji Seva is in this third verse, the very important point that we do it regularly. Nityanana, every day we worship Thakurji if we have properly installed Ishtadev deity. We can worship every day. We can dress him every day. We can offer incense, like I said. So this third verse is very much practical. Like in the second verse, it was kirtan and bhajan, singing, dancing. Now the third verse deals with archanam, with worship of the deity. And we can see that it's very, very pleasing to Sri Gurudev because he himself was showing us the importance. Baba, every morning until his final breath, he came down and he did that. I was amazed to see how beautifully he did that Vigraha Seva every morning. And this was inspiring to see that for us, we should do the same. Of course, Baba, when he was doing it, he was there with them. When we are doing it, we follow him and try to think and focus our consciousness in our Swarup, in our desired form every morning. The difference is he was there as a Siddha Purush and we are trying to get there. So next verse, also a very pleasant item of Bhakti Yoga. Chatur Vita Sri Bhagavat Pasaro Svaranna Triptam Hori Bhokta Sangam Kritvaiva Triptim Pachato Sadeva Ponde Guru Si Charanaravindam. The spiritual master has very big pleasure when devotees eat Bhagavat Prasadam. And not only, he is very detailed, Chakravadipa, detailed, chatur, shvita, four kinds of, and it's licked, chewed, drunk, and slurped, it is said. And Sri Gurudev is very, very happy when the devotees are respecting and honoring Bhagavat Prasadam, food, boga offered to Thakurji. And Sri Gurudev, I also witnessed this many times, Baba was always very happy to see when devotees have been sitting there eating Mahaprasad and his sevaks distributed Mahaprasad. So this is also very, very pleasing to Gurudev when we try to only eat prasadam, only eat offered food to Thakurji every day. This is very, very pleasing. And to such a spiritual master, I offer my very humble obeisances who teaches us the importance of prasadam. It is food from a different world. It is transcendental. It is not different from Krishna. It is packed with mercy, and it is very, very powerful to counteract every mental problems. And we have a higher taste. We taste the love of Krishna and Radha have for us when we eat Bhagavad Prasadam, when we eat Mahaprasad from our Ishtadev, from our deities. It is a very, very, very powerful item, eating Mahaprasad. Everyone can experience that. It's not a big problem. It is very joyful, and Shri Gurudev is very happy if we focus on a diet of pure Bhagavad Prasad. So this is what is said here. Chakravartipad is saying that Shri Gurudev really, really loves it when we engage in offering bhoga to our Thakurji, and when we eat only the offered food, when we only eat prasad. It will help us greatly. It is one of the most powerful items. It is really powerful. It will control our tongue. It will make us remember Krishna. It is said when we eat not prasadam, it is very difficult to remember Krishna, but when we eat every day prasadam, it becomes very easy to remember Krishna and to be in contact with him. It's the most easiest way. We can go deeper and deeper in this, because Radhika is tasting the remnants, and when we offer it, we also taste the love of Radha and Krishna in the Mahaprasad. There are different styles of offering Mahaprasad. We offer it, for example, like it is in the Leela. We first offer to Krishna, and when Krishna has eaten, Radhika and the Sakis eat, and when Radhika and the Sakis have eaten, the Manjaris eat. So like it was written in the Leela, but there are different styles. Some people offer it directly to Radha and Krishna when they are in the Nikunjas together. There is no hard and fast rule. It's just everyone follows a different way. So we follow our way. Someone else offer it differently. The point is you offer it with love and devotion to Thakurji. So this is a very important verse. So then next two verses go very deep. I try to remember everything I heard about this, because these two are really, really wonderful verses. Shri Radhika ma tavayora para matuya lila gunaruponomnam pratikshana svadanna lolupasya vande guru sri charanaravindam. Shri Radhika Mathavayor Apara. Even the first line gives us the direction where our mind and heart should go, Vrindavan. We should go to Vrindavan. Radhika, Shri Radhika Mathava is only present in Vrindavan. So our worship, our bhajan is directed to Vrindavan. Shri Radhika Mathavayor Apara. Madhurya Leela. So, Guna Rupa Namnam. The pastimes, the qualities, the form, and her names, their names, they are without limit. They are limitless. They are without any limit. Apara. So, Madhurya Leela Guna Rupa Namnam, the sweet Madhurya Leela pastimes, their forms and their qualities and their names are limitless, without any limit. So, Pratikshanasva Dhana Lolu Pasya. The Shri Guru always relishes this pastimes, the gunas, the rupa, the form, the qualities. Shri Gurudev is always relishing these unlimited pastimes, forms, qualities, and names of the divine couple. And he is always eager to hear and to chant. So we should follow his footsteps. Here is also a very, very good point. It is written Madhurya Leela. Of course, we know that all our acharyas are Manjari. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur is also Manjari. I forgot now which one he is, but I know for a fact that he is a Manjari. So this is, of course, Madhurya Leela. It cannot be their Vatsalya Leela. It cannot be their Sakha Leela. It cannot be their any other Leela. It can only be their Madhurya Leela, because our acharyas, all of them, have been Manjari, so they suggest us and show us this beautiful, beautiful love, this Madhurya Leela, Guna Rupa Namnam. So Madhurya Ras is the conjugal love of Radha and Krishna, where we can serve them as in a loving exchange. And the zenith, the highest point of Madhurya Lila, is Unarpita Chiram Chirat, Ujjvala Rasam, Sri Bhakti Sriyam. So Sva Bhakti Sriyam is the highest, the love the gopis have for Radha and Krishna is the highest love they can have. Radhika has the highest love for Krishna. So Madhurya Lila, that the peak of Madhurya Lila is in the heart of Radhika. So we can also have entrance now by Mahaprabhu's mercy into the inner circle of Srimati Radhika's girlfriends, the Manjaris, which is considered by the Gaudiya Vaishnava Acharyas as the pinnacle and the zenith of Madhurya Ras. So this love Radhika experiences together with Krishna, the Manjaris also can experience this in their heart because they are tadatmika. They are very close to Srimati Radhika. So all the feelings, even up to bites on lips, can appear with the Manjaris. So this Madhurya Lila, Guna Rupa Namnam, here means that we have to focus and meditate on our Sri Gurudev in Manjari Bhav. As a Mahi is a Manjari, I am a Manjari, and we are together there in this Madhurya Lila, in this wonderful, sweet pastimes of Radha and Krishna together. This is the pinnacle of Madhurya Ras. It's called pinnacle. Unatochvala Ras, the highest. Before Mahaprabhu came, Sakya Ras was there, where you can enjoy erotic pastimes with Krishna yourself. But right, Mahaprabhu gave us a very, very special gift, a very, very, very special mercy to enter and to reject that, to say no, Manjari say no, I don't want to be with Krishna. I only want that my Swamini is together with Krishna. So this very, very special Ras, this beautiful, beautiful Manjari Bhav, where we are not selfish, where we set ourselves back and we promote those and help enable that they meet us. This is what is actually the pinnacle of Madhurya Ras. This is the highest, considered the highest aspect of that Madhurya Lila, so that we can become as assistant and a Manjari of Srimati Radhika. And Sri Gurudev is always tasting and always engaged and focused in this beautiful mood. So such a Gurudev, and who teaches us that Madhurya Lila Guna Rupa Namnam, always when he speaks to such a Gurudev, I offer my respectful obeisances. So such a guru, he can give us the ticket, the entrance card into this beautiful Madhurya Lila Guna Rupa Namnam, because he is a direct associate with Radhika. He has the power and he has the love for us to give us this beautiful, beautiful entrance to be also there in Manjari, as a Manjari, and to be really with Radha and Krishna in the Nikunjas of Vrindavan, which is considered by our Acharyas our goal, our Prayochan, to be in that mood, in that bhav, in this Radhika Sneha, more affectionate towards Srimati Radhika. No, there are three bhavs, the same love for both. More love for Krishna, more love for Radhika. Manjaris are more Radhiksneha, who have more love for Radhika. And our perspective of Madhurya Lila is from this way, that we are always seeing Radhika first and then Radhika's Krishna. So this means this is the deep point of this Madhurya Lila Rupa, Guna Rupa Namnam. Gurudev is experiencing this and that path. Next one is also very nice, beautiful verse. Nikunja yuno radikeli si jai nyaya lipi yukti rapekshaniya tatra didaksha rati valla posya vande guru si charana ravindam. This verse has also very deep meaning. Nikunja yuno radikeli si jai. So Sri Gurudev, he is very, very expert because he's one of the Sakis. But he's not only one of the Sakis. All Manjaris are Sakis, but not all Sakis are Manjaris. So we can see that actually here it means that Sri Gurudev, he's so expert in assisting the divine couple in the Kunjas, Nikunjas of Vrindavan, Nikunja Yuno, and even Radhikeli Sityai. Radhikeli means actually the most amorous pastimes of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna, the most private and also the most intimate pastimes of Radha and Krishna. So Srila Gurudev is there as a huge expert, as a Manjari full of expertise to help and to assist Radha and Krishna in Radhikeli. So we can understand that actually not many people have entrance into Radhikeli. When we read Vilapakusa Manjali and when we read Stava 38 of Raja Vilasa Stava, Raghunath Das Goswami is saying that I prefer to be more a Manjari and not, I'm not eager for friendship. I want to be Kinkari. I want to be a Manjari, because when Radha and Krishna are together in the most personal, intimate way, only the Manjaris can go in and service them and make service to them. So in Radhikeli Sitya, and Sakis cannot enter there. Sakis can help decorate and everything, but most intimate Leela is Sakis cannot go in, only Manjaris can go inside. So that means that this Nikunja Yuno Radhikeli Sitya Yayali Piya Yuktiya Apekshaniya. So Gurudev is making all arrangements and all things to help that Radhikeli can be perfected, Radha and Krishna can have a perfect amorous love play in the Nikunjas. Sri Gurudev is there to make this happen. So we assist him in this way. We are always with Guru Manjari. We always assist him in this making this amorous pastimes happening and making it perfect. So he will give us instructions there in our eternal form, and we can meditate what it is to make flower arrangements, to bring water, scented water, to bring paan, betel nuts, whatever is there. The Manjari is always fanning when they are tired, and all these things you can read in Vilapakusa Manjali, the manual for Manjari Seva. So this is what it means here, Nikunja Yuno, Radhikeli, and of course, Vishwanath Chakravarti part is a Manjari, and of course, he knows that therefore he said this to tell us, this is what we should meditate about when we have our Gurudev in front of us. Not the physical form, but his Manjari form, who is always in the Nikunjas of Vrindavan, expert as a Manjari, assisting and perfecting the Leela, the Radhikeli even. Not, this is really intimate and really personal Leela. He is there. That means that is, he can only be a Manjari. So, Tatradi Dakshat Adiwala Pasya, he is very, very beloved to Srimati Radhika and to Krishna. And because of that, and because Radhika is not shy before him and us, we can enter and do seva in this most sweet and most intimate pastimes. So next verse is Shakshataritvina. This is also a very, very important point in Guru Tattva.
Shakshataritvina samasta shastrai uktastatha bhavyata eva sabhi kentu prapoya kriya eva tasya vande korosi charana ravindam.
So Shakshataritvina samasta shastrai, all revealed scriptures say unisonically that the spiritual master is the direct manifestation of Sri Hari, and because of that, all authority say that he is not different from Krishna. The spiritual master is very, very beloved is very, very much loved by Krishna, because he is his most intimate servant, his most intimate Kinkari, his most intimate Manjari. Such a spiritual master, I bring my most respectful obeisance to the lotus feet of such a spiritual master, who is non-different in a sense from Krishna. Krishna says, I am, Gurudev is my representation, I am the Acharya. Guru Tattva is Guru here in the world, and Samashti Guru is Krishna. So there is a huge connection. It's not to be seen as different. So it's not that Guru, now we should worship Guru as Krishna, but as his representative. So as his, so to say, ambassador, and when we worship him, and it is non-different from Krishna. So all Vedic Shastras say that this, and this is a very big instruction to see and to understand the function and the purpose and the importance of Guru Tattva, that actually it me it, I said in one video before that Krishna is even more pleased when we focus on Guru Bhakti than when we focus on Krishna Bhakti. So to be devoted to Gurudev makes our love for Radha and Krishna even higher. So Krishna gives special mercy, Jiva Goswami is saying, to someone who is more devoted to Guru, because those, because Krishna and Guru are not different, are not apart. So it will augment our love for Shri Radha and Krishna when we have more love for Shri Gurudev. So therefore it is said that all Vedic scriptures unisonically proclaim that Gurudev is the direct manifestation of Sri Hari. He comes into our view as a, with a human body, but we see him as a transcendental form. But we meet him, we speak to him on in the material world. This is when the mercy of Krishna becomes very dense, and Gurudev personifies that mercy of Krishna, so that we can have an exchange, like he's giving us instructions, and we bring down seva to Gurudev, we worship him. So this is a very big and very important point, that he is actually non-different in tattva from Krishna. Guru, Samashti Guru and Diksha, Mantra Guru and Shiksha Guru, that is same level, very, very important point to always keep that in mind, how wonderfully important Gurudev is for our life. So on the last verse, it makes it very clear why. Yasya prasado, Bhagavat prasado, yasya prasado, nakati kutopi jayang stuvang stasya yashasti sandhyam, pande guru sri charanaravindam. So, yasya prasado, Bhagavat prasado, yasya prasado, nakati kutopi. Only by the mercy of Gurudev one can attain the mercy of Sri Krishna, and without attaining the mercy of Guru, there is no goal, no shelter. Nagati kutopi. Gati means goal. Nothing can be attained. So this mercy of Sri Gurudev is the Alpha and it is the Omega. So we should always focus to please Gurudev, to serve Gurudev, and to have him in our heart every day, every moment. So this is a very, very, very important and very hopeful, giving very much hope that actually when we can devote ourselves to our Gurudev, it is very pleasing to Krishna, and every goal can be attained. Like I said in another video, all obstacles in the material world written in the Bhagavatam can be crushed by seva to Gurudev. That is so important, that this mercy of Gurudev is the highest principle for the sadhaka. Everything else comes then as a beautiful bonus, so to say. But we have the possibility to give our lives to Sri Gurudev and to love him, and automatically the love for Radha and Krishna will flow into our heart by his mercy, by his wonderful, wonderful compassion. So therefore it is said, without the mercy, nothing will be attained. It is said that chanting the holy name in the beginning leads one to Gurudev, and chanting under the tutelage and direction of Gurudev will lead you to prema. So Guru is a very, very deep and important subject matter in the Gaudiya Vaishnava Bhakti. So that we focus on Gurudev and his mercy, like I said in the beginning, like this rain cloud is showering down this mercy to extinguish the forest fire. And here again, Chakravartipad comes to enclosure, that this, without this mercy, without this torrential rain of this wonderful nectar mercy cloud, we cannot attain anything. We cannot go from sadhana bhakti to bhava bhakti to prema bhakti to swarup siddhi. Only by the mercy of Gurudev this is possible. So this, therefore it is said, I should remember him at least 3 times a day. So that means morning, midday and night, better every day. And so these 3 sandhyams are mentioned to make the importance. Sometimes 3 is used. Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Hare Nam Eva Kheram, Nastya Vesti, Nastya Eva, Nastya Eva. 3 times sometimes is there to make a point. Very much important. And here, we can do it regularly when we can sit down and remember Gurudev as many times as possible. But Vishwanath Chakravartipat is giving at least three times as better. Of course, we can do it more. So the glories of Guru is really, you should sing it all the time. It's that Jayang Stu Bangs Tasya. The glories of Gurudev can be sung every time. Aha Prabhu Kuru Doya Dehu Mori Padachaya Ebeya Shakushuk Tribhuvana. It's sung all over the world, and we sing it in our hearts every day, and we think about him every day in his form, in his Manjari form. So it is very powerful, a very powerful item for us in bhakti. The last verse is Palashruti, is the what Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakurpat is giving us as a fruit to say, like a result, what will happen when we do, when we sing these eight verses with love and devotion. He will say something. Shrimad Guru Rasta Kameta Duchair Prame Muhurti Potati Prayatna Yastena Brinda Vananata Sakshat Sevaimya Lapya Chanu Santayeva. So who is singing and praying like this eight verses regularly in the Brahma Muhurta very early in the morning, and in a very respectful manner to his beloved Gurudev? When you give up your body, you will attain direct seva to Sri Krishna, the Lord of Vrindavan. Again, Vrindavana Nata Shakshat Seva Eva Lapya Chanu Santa Eva. So that means direct seva can only be attained how? By realizing our Siddhadeya, by realizing our Swarup. And this Vishwanath Chakravartipat is saying, singing these eight prayers every day is a wonderful method to attain the mercy of Gurudev, and by this mercy of Gurudev, really attain Sevaiva Lapya Chadan Sunta Eva, direct Seva to Sri Krishna in Vrindavan, in your desired mood. Like Rupa Goswami is saying, what is your desired mood as a Sakha, as a parental affectionate, as a lover? And here as Gaudiya Vaishnavas, as Mancharis, we focus on that direct seva to Vrindavana Natha, to Lord Krishna in Vrindavan together with Radhika. We focus on that in that mood. Direct seva can only be possible. Now is Manasi seva. Now we do it in our mind. And Narottam Das Thakur is saying from this comes a ripened fruit, and it will be real. From practice becomes perfection. So now we mentally do this. Now is manasa seva, and then it will be direct seva. Shakshat, direct seva. Shakshat means direct. You will be there after you leave this body. You will be engaged in direct seva. This is the Palashruti. This is the promise Vishwanatha Chakravartipat is giving us. If we take this mercy of Gurudev seriously, one day Guru si charanaravindam. What a beautiful, beautiful prayer by Srila Vishwanath Chakravartipat. Dandavats to the Vaishnavas, dandavats to Vishwanath Chakravartipat. Jai Gurudev. Radhe Radhe.